start.
Age spots, cellulitis, rosacea, actinic keratosis, scleroderma, lichen sclerosis, and of course, epsilon sclerosis. Not everyone's skin condition looks the same, though it's not always taken into account. Take, for example, eczema. It's often approached as though there's one textbook variety. This leads to a flurry of misdiagnoses, including the label idiopathic, meaning cause unknown, when someone's skin condition falls outside eczema's narrow definition. The truth is that there are over 100 varieties of eczema and psoriasis. Rosacea is actually one variety of eczema. When someone has a rosacea-style rash on the nose, cheeks, chin, or forehead, it's just a garden variety of eczema that happens to appear on the face, not yet another separate, mysterious skin condition. Lupus is a popular label too. Instead of getting to the bottom of what causes this style of mystery rash, medical communities often tag it as autoimmune, explaining that your body's attacking itself, which is not correct. One misdiagnosis leads to another, one confusion to the next. You don't know what the rash is, you don't know why someone has fatigue, so you put it in the category of lupus. And what's lupus? Medical research and science don't know, which makes it impossible to diagnose properly. It's an arbitrary word for a confusion of symptoms. Hives are another mystery, understood on a basic level as a flurry of histamines causing a rash to develop. If you break out with an acute rash and head to the emergency room, the first thing the doctor's going to say is, "What did you eat?" If you say you had a turkey sandwich, the doctor will likely dismiss food as the cause, because turkey seems so normal. If, on the other hand, you tell the doctor you ate strawberries, the doctor will likely say it seems you're allergic to strawberries. If you ate a ham sandwich, the doctor will say it's not the cause of your hives. If you ate an apple, the doctor will blame the apple. If you ate a slice of pizza, the doctor will say that wasn't the problem. If you ate granola, the doctor will say oats, nuts or seeds are to blame. If you ate chocolate ice cream, the doctor will say, that's not it. If it was raspberry sorbet, the doctor will say, that's the source. That's the way doctors are taught to think, and their training will come across as certainty, even though those assumptions about which food can cause a reaction aren't always right. If there's no obvious, normal explanation, and the hives are reoccurring with no discernible pattern, nothing to connect the dots, doctors will often throw them into the idiopathic chronic allergy realm. Translation? We don't know why you're having these reactions. If the skin condition persists, then these days doctors are very likely to call it autoimmune, that is, to make that lupus diagnosis. If it's not enough to say that it's allergic or autoimmune, they'll blame it on genes. Someone you have a skin condition because your mother, father, or an earlier ancestor suffered with one makes surface level sense that stops everyone from digging deeper. Even if your foremothers and forefathers didn't suffer from skin conditions, it will be called genetic. Doctors want to have answers for patients, which is honourable and makes it all the more unfortunate that they're not always the right answers. Unwanted liver residues. What do mystery rashes really stem from? Almost every single skin condition comes from the liver. The intestinal tract often becomes involved by default in a forced collaboration. However, conditions labelled eczema, psoriasis, rosacea, lupus, cellulitis, vitiligo, age spots, other discolorations, and more start and end with the liver. Even acne and cellulite derive from the liver. More on acne in the next chapter. These conditions visions begin because something gets inside the liver that shouldn't be there. Is there anything inside your home that shouldn't be there? Dirt, clutter, garbage, spiders, dust mites, a gas leak? These problems seem to have a way of...